Hi everyone and welcome to this Placeit tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a cool gaming logo just like one of these. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Hey everyone and welcome to this Placeit tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a gaming logo using Placeit. There are a ton of options and it's super easy to use and customize a logo even if you don't have any graphic design experience. First things first, if you are new to Placeit, I recommend going over to Placeit. I put my affiliate link down in the description. That will give you 15% off. So if you don't have a plan already, I recommend using that. That would help me out on this channel, and also it gives you a 15% discount, so it should be a win-win. Now, if you don't have a Placeit subscription at all, stick around to the end of this video because I'll show you a similar free way to make a cool logo using Placeit as well, and you won't need a subscription for that. So I recommend watching this video all the way through. With that out of the way here, let's go ahead and get started with the gaming logo. So first things first, once you're logged into Placeit, you can hover over logos or gaming. It's both going to take you to the same place if you hover over logos and go to gaming teams, or if you go to gaming and then logos. They'll both bring you to this page here. And once you're here, you can browse all of their templates that are ready to go. If you hover your mouse over it, it'll show you some of the graphics that can go on or the ways that you can customize them in different ways. Now, if you go all the way to the bottom, you can see all of the pages they have. They've got 76 pages as of right now of different logos you can customize for gaming, and they add to these basically daily. Now, with that said, up at the top, you can put in your team name up here and it'll show you what they look like mocked up on these. I don't recommend doing that. It's going to take a little bit more CPU on your computer. So I recommend just going through and seeing what you really like. And then once you click on that, then you can start to customize the text. So for the sake of this tutorial, let's go ahead and customize one of these. The one that I really like is this one right here. So I'm just going to click on it. It'll bring us right into this and we can start to customize everything here. So very first thing that I want to show you here is that it has a black background right here. And if you do need to create a PNG with a transparent background, all you've got to do is click background and then hit the little checkerboard right here. And what that's going to do is take the background color out entirely. So when you actually download this design, you'll have just this logo that you can put over top of anything. Now, if you don't need a clear background, you can set this to any color that you prefer. And then there's a few things that we have to note here. So over on the left here are our text boxes. So if we turn them on or off, it'll take them out of our design over here. And anytime you make a change, it just takes a couple seconds to process and show that change on the screen. Additionally, you can go ahead and change the color of what that text is. And you can go in and change the actual font of what that text is. Typically though, on all of these designs and the templates, they come with the fonts that generally look the best for this specific design. So I don't really think you should have to change too much here. Now to change the text, all you gotta do is highlight in here and change it to your team name or whatever you want written here. And then coming over to the other side, we can change the colors of the design. So we have our main color and our accent color. As you can see, you can kind of match them up to what they are. So if we change the accent color to something more of a dark green, it'll reflect that in the design. I think that looks really good. And if we did want to play with the main color, we can change that as well. Now, hands down, the reason that I recommend using Placeit is because you're going to be able to choose from their graphics on the side. All you have to do is click one of these, and then it will change your design and integrate it into it. As you can see, the border updates, and it really is a clean transition. Now, if you don't use Placeit, you're going to have to edit these things manually, and trust me when I say in Photoshop, you're not going to be able to change up different graphics this quickly. So these designs all look really cool. I actually really like this one. This wasn't the one I created for the thumbnail, but let's go ahead and show you how to download one of these. So once you like it, everything looks good. Like I said, you can take out the background if you need to, but when you're good to go, all you click is download. And then it will remind you that it will be 4,000 pixels by 4,000 pixels. There's no watermark on it, high resolution PNG. And keep in mind that each different logo that you create comes with a different aspect ratio. So yours may not be 4,000 by 4,000. It may be, for example, 5,000 by 4,000. And the last thing that is most important here is commercial usage is okay. This means that if you were to put this on merch or something that you were profiting from, that is completely okay as long as you have a subscription to Placeit. Now, the big thing to note here is even after your subscription to Placeit expires, let's say you only get 1 month subscription and you download this, it still carries its full commercial usage rights after your subscription has expired. So you do not have to continue paying for the subscription if you've already got all the graphics you want. So once you're all set here, all you click is download now. And you'll see this pop-up come up in the corner, say your request is now processing. It'll show that it's loading up top. And then in a second here, a pop-up will come up and say that the processing has been complete and you can just click to download it. Now the processing has just finished and we can click here to download that. It'll download it straight to our computer and we can just click to open that up. And just like that, we've got our downloaded logo right here and it is great quality 4,000 by 4,000. So you should be able to zoom in as far as you need to. Now with that said, you can download as many of these as you want to. If you get a subscription, it comes with unlimited downloads, so you're not limited. And if you need to get something different of a different style over here, just take out the search term, type in anything you need to, and you can continue to click different graphics. Now, as promised in the beginning of this video, I said I'd show you a way to do this for free if you don't have a subscription to Placeit, and that's what I want to show you right now. So if you go back to Placeit, just click the homepage here. And if you hover over mockups or designs and then click free, one will say free designs, one will say free mockups. Again, they'll take you both to this same page here. This is going to be all of Placeit's free designs or mockups, logos, everything that they have here that's free that you don't actually need to have a subscription. So with that said, you're not going to get as good quality of those gaming logos that you saw before. However, you can scroll through all of these until you find something that looks kind of attractive, something you would be tempted to use as a logo. Again, at this point, they have 15 different pages of free designs, but there are some that might interest you. So for example, if we just go through and we click something like this one here, just for an example, this is kind of an illustration style look, but what you can do here is this text, again, we can move to whatever we need to. We can make the background transparent if we want to, but if we take out the search here, we have all of these different designs that come up. So we can click things like this, and these graphics are all free to use and free to download. So again, you're not going to get the full customization that you saw in the gaming logos, but this is a good free way to do this if you don't have a Placeit subscription. Then you just kind of have to customize the text and change the color to make it look how you want it to. A little bit more difficult than what I was showing you previously, but this definitely is a free way to do this if you don't have a Placeit subscription. All right, guys, I hope this tutorial has helped you to create a gaming logo on Placeit. If you have any questions, let me know down in the comments. And like I said before, the discount code, which is my affiliate link over to Placeit, is down in the description. If you do use that, thank you so much. That helps support this channel, and it should give you a good discount when you sign up. All right, guys, that's it for this one. If you have any specific tutorial requests, let me know down in the comments, and I'll be seeing you guys in the next video.